So after reviewing the auth control, let's now get into the recipe controller. So this is the recipe controller. It basically has the CRUD functions needed for the recipe. It can fetch a recipe list, update the recipe, create recipe. Ubuntu recipe means I actually have named the functionality of liking or reacting to a recipe as Ubuntu recipe. Like means if the user likes the recipe or gives a smiley or gives a prayer to the recipe, the respective count of that recipe will be incremented respectively or decremented respectively. Whatever the reaction is, smiley, prayer, or like. So basically, what happens is that I have managed it using means the recipe will be consisting of list of reacted users. So whenever if the some user reacts to a recipe, I will first check whether that user is exist in the list of that recipe, Ubuntu list of the recipe. So if the user exists, then it means that user has already acted on that recipe with a specific type. Means if there is a user and user one, then if he likes the recipe, I will simply store that user ID into the list of Ubuntu list of the recipe. If the user one has given a like, means the Ubuntu type will be like. So I will match the user ID and user Ubuntu type, and if they are equal, that means particular user have already reacted with like. So I will simply decrement the Ubuntu, means I will remove that user from the list. I use splice method for that. And if the user doesn't exist, that means this is the first time the user have been reacting with particular reaction. So I will simply add that user object into the Ubuntu list of the recipe. So every user can react with a particular type only once. So that is the logic written in here. And this is a function that simply converts the string to an object ID. It comes handy when dealing with the Mongoose object types, entity types. So that is all for the recipe controller. Next, we will be going into the comment controller.